Hello, it's Barbara. I have an assignment for you in Quiet Town, just outside of New York City. A newspaper shop owner named Mrs. Brooks was murdered there on Sunday morning. Before that, a local small business owner named Mr. Asher was killed. Murders are rare in such a quiet town, so this case sparked my interest. I thought you could write an article about it. Sound good?
Good evening. You're a reporter, right? I'm glad you came. If the case is made public, we'll have a better chance of catching the criminal. Miriam and Richard divorced a few months before her death, so we don't know where he lives now. After their divorce, he went to Miriam's several times and made a scene, so he's our prime suspect. I don't know why they quarreled so much. The police already examined the crime scene, but they could have missed something. I can't live a peaceful life while my aunt's murderer is on the loose. Please, examine the room and show me what you find.
Thank you.
letters are from Richard. The last one was sent shortly before Miriam's death, and there's a return address. Finally, know where he lives. You need to get to him before he has a chance to hide somewhere. Thank you for your help, and good luck.
Oh, thank you for helping me, but let's cut to the chase. I have an idea who might have killed Miriam. Maybe it was the moneylender Asher advised her to reach out to. When Miriam was behind in her payments, that man started sending her threatening letters. Perhaps he wanted to show other people who owed him money what could happen if they didn't pay. I didn't call the police because I was afraid it would put Miriam in more danger. The moneylender could have taken revenge on me by harming her. I can't help you because I'm wounded, but please try to follow the attacker. I'll call the police in the meantime. And here, take this. It will help get you out of here.
Hello. I'm Constable Harold Kane. Richard Brooks called the police and told me what happened. I followed the same lead as you. But it's not that simple. The door's locked, so we have to find a way to get inside.
Well done. You make a good policeman. Unfortunately, we're too late. The murderer is probably elsewhere by now. I'd still like to examine the house. Please, be careful. If you find something, let me know.
think it's the moneylender's list of debtors. Mr. Asher and Mrs. Brooks' surnames have already been crossed off the list. Mrs. Collins' name is underlined in red. It appears the killer goes after his victims in alphabetical order. So? Mrs. Collins is next. I'm sure the moneylender went to kill her. We have to go to her house, now!
Oh, good evening. I've been waiting for you. I knew a stubborn reporter like you would follow me. Listen. If you do what I say, I'll let Mrs. Collins go. Otherwise, her death is on your hands. First, you have to bring me her documents. I'll use them to sell her business. Second, bring me the key from her car. And last but not least, get me her wallet with the money she owes me. So, will you do it, or will you let her die?
I'm afraid we don't have a choice.
Thank you.
I'm glad you've made the smart choice.
Quick! Go after him! drop the knife! Now! I'm so grateful for your help. I couldn't have dealt with this alone. I'm sure you'll become a great reporter.
You've written an excellent article. From now on, you're officially a crime reporter. Congratulations.